Hello everyone, today we are going to talk about adversion. In order to cover our interesting topic, we have to answer a few questions. First, what is it? And we will talk about the definition of the word. Second, what is it for? And we will read simple examples. Third, the types of adversion. There are two main types of adversion. And number four, why do we need it? The purpose of inversion. And five, tasks. You will do some tasks in order to practice and you will learn skill. The first question is, what is it? The word inversion has two different pronunciations in British English. The first one is with the sound J, inversion. And the second one is with the sound sh, inversion. I will be using the first one, inversion. The Cambridge Dictionary gives us a simple definition of the term. A situation in which something is changed so that it is the opposite of what it was before. Or in which something is turned upside down. The Oxford definition is the following. The act of changing the position or order of something to its opposite, or of turning something into a position in which the top of it is where the bottom of it normally is. For instance, the inversion of normal word order. What is it for? Inversion happens when we reverse the normal word order of a structure. Most commonly the subject-verb word order. For example, a statement has the subject S before the verb V, but to make question word order, we invert the subject and the verb with an auxiliary aux or modal verb M before the subject S. For example, a simple sentence. You are happy. In order to make a question, we have to invert R and you. As a result, are you happy? It is possible to do the same way with every tense in English grammar. For example, he will be eating ice cream same time tomorrow. Will be eating. Future continuous tense. The question will he be eating ice cream same time tomorrow? Will instead of he. They switched places. Inversion happened. This is an inverted word order. Another example. I have seldom seen such beautiful work. We could invert the word seldom and put it in the first place. Seldom have I seen such beautiful work. Let's talk about the types of inversion. The first type is a subject-verb inversion or full inversion. The subject is preceded by the entire verb phrase. For example, best of all would be to get a job in Wellingham. To get a job in Wellingham is the subject of a sentence. The verb here is would be and the adverbial part best of all. Another type is subject operator inversion or partial inversion. The subject is preceded only by the operator rather than by the main verb or full verb phrase. For example, not before in our history have so many strong influences united to produce so large a disaster. The subject of a sentence here, so many strong influences. The verb of a sentence, have united. So the subject in this case is inserted between the auxiliary verb and the past participle. And the first part of a sentence, not before in our history, adverbial part, is put in the first place in the sentence, in the beginning of the sentence. So we need two words in order to make inversion. Have, united, auxiliary verb and participle. If we don't have that, we have to use the verb to do, here in the past tense. Never again did I think of disobedience. Did, we add here, because we inverted the word order. Never again did I think of disobedience. Because English sentence can have only one negative part, negation, we could have said, I didn't think of disobedience ever again. But we inverted the word order and put the subject of a sentence not on the first place in the sentence, but on the third in this case. And so we inverted. Never again did I think of disobedience. In a minute we will see more examples. Subject-verb inversion. We have a simple sentence structure here. Adverbial part will be the first in the sentence. Verb in the second place and subject a third. Initial adverbials. So adverbials will be in the first place. For example, here comes the first question. Here is the adverbial part. Comes the verb. First question is the subject of a sentence. Here came the scouts. Clever, graceful, quiet. They had rifles. Next came the anti-tank gunner. First, next is the adverbial part. Came is the verb part. And the subject follows. Inversion. There's the dog. Call the dog. There's, if we ask a question, so the question will be where. So we have here there. The direct word order would have been the dog is there. But we stressed the word. We paid more attention there to the word there. There's the dog. Call the dog. The next example is almost the same, but with a cat and the chair. On the chair lay a cat. A cat is a subject, lay, the verb. On the chair is a stressed part, the adverbial of place. A few more examples. Here comes the bus. There goes the train. Inverted word order. Comes the bus. The bus and the train are the subject of a sentence. We have to say something about the following sentence. Here they come. No inversion here, due to the subject being a pronoun. If we have a subject as a pronoun, inversion does not happen. That's a rule you have to memorize. One more example from the literature. Into the lane where he sat there, opened three or four garden gates. Charles Dickens. Opened, the verb of a sentence, three or four garden gates, the subject of a sentence, and into the lane where he sat there, the adverbial part. The first place, the second place, and the third place. Adverbial, verb, and subject, respectively. Subject operator inversion. It contains mostly the negative or restrictive opening elements such as neither, nor, never, nowhere, on no condition, not only, hardly, no sooner, seldom, little, less, only, etc. For example, never have I seen such an exciting match. Partial inversion. Seen is a participle in its own place, as it usually is, but have and I and never are inverted. Never is in the first place, and I, the subject, is in the third place in the sentence. The same happens with present tense. Seldom do we go out since I took up Spanish classes. Seldom takes the first place in the sentence. We insert do in order to make an inversion, partial inversion, auxiliary verb here. And another example from the classical literature. Not a hint, however, did she drop about sending me to school. Bronte. Again, not a hint. Negation. Negative sentence. Negative part. Did, auxiliary verb, as here, do, did. She drop, as here, go out. Verb, the verbal part. Also, subject operator inversion can be made, can be formed, when we have degrees of expression with such word as so and such, neither and nor. For example, a short dialogue. I love chocolate yogurt. So do I. She was a talented artist. So was her brother. Jack London. So were the day away. The day is the subject of the sentence. Were is the verb. So we put it in the first place because it's a degree expression. So we have checked a few examples and we have seen about the inversion. So why do we need it? First of all, it's a word economy, as we saw in the dialogues, short dialogues. Word economy is when less is in fact more. We use less words to say more. Down he fell. It sounds poetic. Quotation from Mansfield. We could have said he fell down, direct word order, nothing changed. But down he fell, so you can hear in my voice the stress. So I put a lot of pressure on that word. I put a lot of stress there. Down he fell. So I wanted to say something more than just he fell down. And grammar rules are important. They make our speech clear and natural. For example, we can say it was a strange place. But it's a direct word order. It does not make the sentence very vivid. If we use inversion, as Charles Dickens did, a strange place it was, you can hear again in my voice that maybe it sounds more natural. What do you think? And one more part. Literary techniques or stylistic devices activate our mind and allow us to learn something new or anew. For example, Charles Dickens. Bright eyes they were. Synecdoche and inversion. We have two stylistic devices in one sentence. Now it's your turn. Tell me, what is the correct pronunciation of the word? Inversion. Second question. How many types of inversion are there? Correct, two. What's the main difference between the first and the second type? Right, the first type is when we change places with subject and the verb, and we put the object in the first place in the sentence. And the main difference between the first and the second type, we put a lot of negative words, negations, at the beginning of a sentence. What type is it? Only once did he meet his match in tennis. Correct, the second type. Sweet was that evening, Bronte. The first type. Of his love, he would tell her nothing. Voynich. The first type. Not a hansom did I meet with all my drive. Jack London. The second type. Change the sentence that it would start with the word seldom. Change the sentence so that it would start with the word never before. Now, change the sentence so that it would start with the word had. Now change the sentence that it would start from the word speedily. Swedish honey, be your learning. Thank you.